الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله، وأشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى آتاه الله اليقين. الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الكهف He is sending to us a very eye-opener message. And this message it says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألا أنبئكم بالأخسرين أعمالا الذين ضل سعيهم في الحياة الدنيا وهم يحسبون أنهم يحسنون صنعا. Let me tell you the genuine losers of this life. They are the one that they went through the life thinking what they do qualify them to Allah forgiveness and Allah mercy. But in reality, they are not. They lost themselves, they lost the chance because they follow the hawa. When you ask every human being, there is no such a thing called a human being does not recognize the fact of death. We all, regardless believer or not, what kind of believe or not, it is all, they believe, we all believe in death because we see it. And most of the mankind, They believe by internal life, one form or another. But when you come to the Muslim and you ask them where you want to go after death, immediately it comes to the word al-Jannah. And guess what? When every and each one of us say it, I honestly believe him. That's exactly what you want. You want the Jannah. But look to what your hand is doing. Is your hand and your heart and your mind and your body and your legs walking you toward that goal or taking you away on the other direction? Where are you going? What you doing? Are you on the right direction? Do you do what you know it is right or you do what you think it is right? Here, most of us, unfortunately, we are very good in deceiving our own self. And once you start deceiving your own self, you are the first and the only. When you deceive others, they are your victim. Just getting into the concept of deceiving, you are the victim number one. When it comes to deceiving your own self, you are the one and the only victim to yourself. This is facts. But how are we deceiving ourselves? How are we in reality betraying ourselves? How in reality we claim that we love ourselves and we are destroying ourselves? That's what this seer is going to be about. Inshallah, this khutbah going to be a beginning of a series. And this series, it says, know your enemy. Know your enemy. It may take between 5 to 6 khutbah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. But it is very important to know the concept and the facts. Inshallah, they will be included in this series. To start with, you need to know who is your enemy. If you sincerely want to go to Jannah, if you know by your mind what it takes to do it, why you are not doing it, there is something holding you back. You are diverted. What taking you away? Who is your enemy? First of all, let us come back and see what the word enemy mean. We have the habit. Unfortunately, we have the habit to call whomever in conflict with my idea about myself or my interest, I call him my enemy. You come and threat my ego. You threat how I see myself. I sense you are having better quality in some issues better than me. You are my enemy. Jealousy. There is a conflict between what you do and what I need and what I do. You are my enemy. You compete with me in the business. You compete with me in whatever the subject is. You are my enemy. But in reality, that's not your enemy. In a true essence of it, that cannot be the enemy. Who is the enemy? The enemy, whatever, can take you away from Allah's mercy. That is your true enemy. The one who takes you away from Allah's mercy. We Muslim pray 5 times a day. And for everyone we say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. I am not going to go through the end of it, but what does that mean? That means I am Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling you back 5 times a day. Say, come on, I'm going to forgive you. How you doing? Where you stand now? Do you need help? I'll give it to you. When you say La ilaha illallah, you are saying, I am obeying none but you, Ya Allah. So going back to who is your enemy, the worst enemy that you can get is the one between your ribs. You can be the enemy number one to yourself. أَأَنْتَ تَهْدِي مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَى يَا مُحَمَّد. Don't waste your time with whomever glorified himself. Follow his own. It comes in the lead who is taking you away from Allah's mercy is Shaitan. So the series about know your enemy. Know the Shaitan. Know the one who is taking you away from Allah's mercy and divert you. Inshallah, in these khutbas, we will study who is he, how he works, what happened before, what kind of tools he got, what kind of tools Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you, and what kind of encounters is going on, and how to stand up for yourself. And unfortunately also we will find out how we are helping him. Can you imagine you have an enemy and you are helping that enemy? We start by who is the Shaitan? The Shaitan is a creature from al-jinn. To understand as much as you can from al-fiqh, one of the main keys is to understand the meaning of the word. What does the word jinn mean? The jinn, it means something that you know by your 5 senses it exists but you cannot realize. So jinn, that means there is a partition between you and him. You cannot see him, you cannot hear him, you cannot touch him, you can not use the 5 senses to realize, but you know that it is there, like death. So when even you say the word Jannah, you know it is there, but you cannot describe it. Physically you can't. And this is where it comes to the word Jinn. Al-Jinn is a creature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him from fire. And other creatures, like any other creature, like the angels, like others. And in a way, interact with our life. For that creatures, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him certain credentials. He can move fast, very fast, and he can have a different physical shape sometimes. In the beginning, he was worshipping Allah. In a lot of times, we think that when we hear the word or the act or the word worshipping, we think it is like a prayer and fast and rituals. No. In reality, worshipping means what? Unconditional obedience to Allah. That's the worshipping. Sami'na wa ata'na. That is the worshipping. So in the beginning, he was. And he was residence of heavens with angels. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the choice, and in the first trial, he failed. We need to know how he failed. What did he do wrong? And compare what he did do wrong and the consequence of that with what we are doing. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the choice, and in the first trial, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the malaika and ordered him to make sujood. And sujood is not sujood of submission, but sujood of respect and acceptance to Adam, he refused. And that means here he did what? A challenge, or did not respond to the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his choice. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him, ما منعك ألا تسجد إذ أمرتك؟ قال أنا خير منه، خلقتني من نار وخلقته من طين. So now, the first major mistake that he did, it was what? Act of obedience. The second, he make it worse by what? I try to give a logical explanation to it. Give excuse why he did it. When Allah asked him, and Allah all-knowing, he said what? Ana khayrun min. I am better than him. And he started to give reasons. We can understand from that what? You can logic anything. You can have excuse for anything. But that does not mean it is right. You can even deceive yourself and end up feeling you are a victim and you had to do what you had to do, and in reality, no, it was not. So he was here cheating his own self. And the first crime and the only crime it was in that stage is what? He challenged the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he favored himself over others. And that's a crime. One thing before I leave this point, and I urge you to do it, please. Never, ever, never, never do it, never allow it to compare yourself with anyone or anything. Allah created you to be unique. You are one in a kind in the kind. In the mankind, you are one in a kind. One incident will never be repeated again. Don't bleed your energy and bleed your soul and bleed your life trying to compare yourself with others. Everyone got his own trial material. Everyone got his own preparations. Everyone got his own test. Get busy. Get busy with it instead of comparing yourself with others. And feel sorry for what you got and what you don't. It is not important what you got. More important what you do with what you got. So for him, instead of after realizing the mistake, instead of admit it, seek forgiveness what he did. He gave a logical explanation and he did stand by his mistakes. And what is the consequence? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take him away from his mercy. قال فخرج منها فإنك رجيم. لا إله إلا الله. فخرج منها فإنك رجيم. I want to stop a minute for the word فخرج منها. What is it that you are coming out of it? Is Allah mercy. What is Allah mercy? Which is, it is one of the main backbone on a certificate, it called Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Fatiha. What you say? You say what? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. You start with it. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Backbones. What does the Rahman mean? The one who prevent harm before it happened. That's the Rahman. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ, that means my mighty is big enough to prevent any harm to any of my creatures before it happened. وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. And that is that only? No. But also part of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mercy is he makes his forgiveness supersede his anger. Part of the mercy, he makes his forgiveness to be faster than his anger. When you get out of Allah's mercy, what's going to happen? His anger will be a lot more faster than his forgiveness. Walayazu billah. You see where we are putting ourselves in? Another thing, I want to have it with you as a lion. Hold on to it till not the end of this khutbah, but till the end, inshallah, of this series of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want. How many mistakes the shaitan did? Only one single one. And like we know, mistakes, they don't come single, they come plural. Like amalul khair, the good deed, they don't come single, they come plural also. They come together, groups. So you need to know, keep that in mind. One wrongdoing got the shaitan in that position. That's the time to evaluate what you are doing and see how many mistakes you are doing per whatever. His animosity للإنسان to the mankind is permanent. Why? Because he considered the human being is the one who is responsible for getting him outside of Allah's mercy. He wouldn't admit a mistake. You see how arrogant? Does that sound familiar? Sound familiar? Ana khayrun min. I am better than you. And when it comes to the mistake, it is a lot more clear than the sun. Instead of you admit it, you give excuses and you will never admit it. And who pay? You. And what he said out of anger when he found out, وَخْرُجْ مِنْهَا, you are out of my mercy. Look to how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deal with even with the disobedient. قَالَ فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي. Oh Lord, remember the shaitan said what? وَعِزَّتِكَ لَأَغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِي. The issue here is not a knowledge. If you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the mighty, the one who cannot conquer, the one who cannot change his will or his action, or can challenge it or can defeat it or even delay it, That is a believer. That is a knowledgeable being. No question about it. He put his hand on the core. But what did this knowledge benefit him for? Nothing. It came to be against him instead of it comes in his favor. That's another trap we have to understand. Acceptance of Allah is not how much knowledge you know. Acceptance of Allah is what you do by what you know. How you use it to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not to take you further away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-A'raf, قَالَ فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ I will sit in the straight path to make sure that none will come into it. And in Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَعْنَهُ اللَّهُ قال لأتخذن من عبادك نصيبا مفروضا ولا أضلنهم ولا أمنينهم ولا آمرنهم فليبتكن آذان الأنعام فليغيرن خلق الله ومن يتخذ الشيطان وليا من دون الله فقد خسر خسرانا مبينا. In this Surah An-Nisa, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, Allah took him out of his mercy and he said, I will do my best to deceive and divert as much as I can. As I'll take with me in this one, out of that race, what it called human being, I'm going to take as much as I can. But there is one category I know from the beginning I cannot handle. And I'm not going to waste any time in it. Do you know what is this category? And I hope inshallah we all will be among this category. إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ الْمُخْلَصِينَ Except the one who will unconditionally, sincerely obey you. And inshallah it will be, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, it's going to be another khutbah about the sincerity, al-ikhlas. What is the component? How we get it? And how we raise it as attributes in our characters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him so many names in the Holy Quran. One of them is the shaitan. And what the shaitan means? The one who rebellion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also call him a ta'ud, tyrant. And what does that mean? That he passed his limitation. Claim rights does not belong to him and worship himself. Okay, let us go back again in this one. Who is the ta'ud, the tyrant? Past his limitation. Claim rights that it does not belong to him. And claim himself as a deity to be worshipped. But somebody gonna come and say, wait a minute. Where are you coming and tell us that he said, worship me? Or he claimed himself to be worshipped? And you just said in the khutbah, I just said less than 5 minutes ago, he said, وَعِزَّتِكَ لَأَغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ By your mighty and glory. That means he was worshipping Allah. How he got from worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to completely worship himself? The answer is this. What it make it or break it, who you obey. If you are sami'na wa ata'na, we hear and we obey, you worship Allah. When you do what you think you are, ought to do, or you what's good for you, and that's called اتِّبَاعُ الْهَوَى, following your own, you already declare yourself a God. You see now where is the problems that happen? The minute you come out of the jurisdiction of obeying Allah, go to obeying yourself, that is the second you declare yourself a God. You clear the divinity. وَالْعِيَزُ بِاللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also called him Iblis. And what does the word Iblis mean? Iblis means the one that there is no goodness can come from him. Pure evil. وَالْعِيَزُ بِاللَّهِ. And he has no chance. In Allah's mercy. Look at it this way. What the khutbah is about is the act of obedience. The issue is the act of obedience. And the shaitan is a role model for what the act of obedience can do or not do to you. You are talking about, here we are talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who declared, رحمتي وسعت كل شيء. My mercy is so wide, so big, it can contain anything. And he is the same one who said, كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. He declared, Allah committed himself to deal with you with mercy. He doesn't have to, but he decided that. When you, that can show you how ugly and how serious and how bad the act of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How devastating. And we are talking about how many? One. We are talking about only one. To know also the magnitude of what I'm talking about. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى استغفر الله العظيم. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to heaven and earth, ائتيا طوعا أو كرها. Come by your choice. Or I will force you to do it. What did they say? أتينا طائعين. أتينا طائعين. Unconditionally we submit. Unconditionally we obey. Unconditionally we obey. Imagine heaven and earth. They are saying, we cannot afford it. We cannot afford this one. Ataina ta'ihi. We wholly, completely submit to your might. And like I said, the reason for this all animosity to the human being, that the shaitan hold the human being responsible for getting him out of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mercy. And he wouldn't admit, he will not admit that he was wrong. You see how arrogant, how things like this. When you disobey Allah, don't look at the act of disobedience. Look to who you are disobeying. Look at what only one act of disobedience can do to you. And I'm going to give you one, I'm going to close the inshallah this khutbah by telling you some of the scenarios. Some of the scenarios that it will take place in the day of judgment. Because there is a going on. There is a battle now going on between the human being and between who? Shaitan. Between the shaitan. The shaitan said, Ya Allah, I was a bitter believer. I am one who submit to you bitter. There is, inshallah, going to be a complete khutbah about that day. But now I want to mention two things very quickly to put the things in composure. Number one, when we get to that level, we will find out that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using past tense. He's using past tense. And we know, any linguistic, he knows a difference between the past tense, the present, and the future. But why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using the past tense? Because to the human being, the only reality is the past. I can ask you the question. Did you have a breakfast? The answer going to be yes or no. But I'm going to say, are you going to have a dinner? You say maybe. Maybe did. I don't know. So it is unknown. It cannot be reality. Now, I still don't know because I didn't finish what I'm doing. You can come and ask me, did you give the khutbah? I don't know. I can drop dead now. The khutbah will not going to be completed. I don't know. What is the only reality that I can realize, recognize, and speak about and be responsible for is the past. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looking and sending in the Quran the message, I want you to deal with these facts that it will take place in the future as if it is a past, because that's exactly how it's going to happen. Don't forget that. The second, when it is gathered together, now the shaitan going to come and say, Ya Allah, in the beginning, I said, I gave the claim, I am better than him. Today, I like, please, to plead my case. I like to plead, to open the trial again. I am coming now today, showing you, proving to you, what the majority of that Adam and his sons and daughter did. I'm going to prove to you, who are the killers? Who are the tyrant? Who are the disbelievers? Who are the hypocrite? Who are the one who associate with you? Who one been zalim to himself and to zalim to others? And the majority. So I was right. And here is the answer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You and them to the hellfire. لا يسأل عما يفعل وأنتم تسألون. No one can dare to ask Allah what you do. But you have to answer to for everything you do. Never forget that. Allah Lordship. Lordship. Give him the right to do what he wants, when he wants, how he wants. Only the Lordship. I'm not talking about the mighty. I'm not talking about the mighty. And I'm not going to talk about the will either. At the end of Surah Yasin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ فَسُبْحَانَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ مَلَكُوتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. For you to do anything, you have to take the means. You have to take the means. And you need knowledge to do it. And till you may not doing it. Or doing it right. But all the control and the domain and the mighty of Allah, all it takes, be it. It's done. That's the one you are disobeying. That is exactly the one you are disobeying. And you are disobeying him for what? Let us seek from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to lighten our nature. And forgive all our sin. And all our mistake. All our shortcoming. We admit our guilt. And we only plead for mercy. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us this mercy. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us again the straight path. That we, inshallah, we will walk through it with sincerity this time. And ask Him to give us the wisdom and the courage to study the teaching of the Holy Quran and the teaching of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and apply Him in our life so we can live in peace and we can die in peace. And inshallah, in the hereafter, we will be in peace and will be among the companion of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in paradise. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله لا إله إلا الله mean none to be obeyed other than him even if I have to disobey myself وأشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه الله اليقين. إن شاء الله I'm going to finish this khutbah by saying what we can do now. We may not see each other again. It is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm positive every and each one of you have at least in his lifetime one or more incidents where the unsudden death happened. Unexpected death happened, and we don't have any guarantee. But in the meanwhile, what we need to do? Allah said it. Because we're going to find out in this conversation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said what He's going to do. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I will permit you to use those tools. But at the same time, he prepared the human being and we will learn how he did it. And we will go to the first trial of the first counter, which is between Adam and Eve and between the shaitan. But at this conversation, in that meeting, in that session, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the solution and give us the quick one. He said, لَأَغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ I will turn them all. I'm going to sit in the straight path to divert them one way or another. I'm going to do it. I'm going to make every and single one of them a professional disobedient. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. And in return, if any of them come to me with the Lord of the heaven and earth, mistakes and sin and sincerity, seek forgiveness one time, I will grant it. And look at the other commitment, other law, other promise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given the Holy Quran as an emergency law to help you. When he said what? وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِيهِمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِيهِمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ We will never punish them, Ya Muhammad, while you are among them. And Muhammad can be among them, among us, by his Sunnah and the Quran. Don't get him out. You need him. And the second, Al-Istaghfar. Sincerely say Astaghfirullah. Allah giving you a chance. How long it takes? What kind of an effort it takes to say Astaghfirullah? Sincerely Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah. Innahu kana ghaffara. Allah is the forgiving. Use this credential. Run back. Stop arguing. See who you are disobeying and who you need. Don't meet Allah love. Don't meet Allah passion. Don't meet Allah mercy. Don't meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kindness with cruelness of a disobedient. And you are the only victim for it. And remember, every time you hear Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Iqamat al-Salah, this is a call from Allah. It says, come back, I will forgive you. Come, just come. Don't be shy. And don't lose hope in my forgiveness. Some people, even when we treat each other, we can hurt each other that bad to the point I say, I cannot even go back to him. I damage the relationship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, no. I'm going to keep the relationship as long as you want it. As long as you are after it. As long as you are seeking it, and I am the mighty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the mighty. The one who can say, I don't need you, I don't need the universe, I don't need none of you. All your disobedience will not going to harm me. All your obedience will not going to benefit me. It is all for you. He is still out of his love and kindness and mercy giving you that robe. Use it. Train your tongue to say Astaghfirullah. That can help you. Train him. Train your say to say Astaghfirullah. Let us seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And ask him to grant us mercy and wipe out all our sin, all our mistakes, all our shortcomings, and purify our heart. So inshallah, it will be a residence of Iman, a residence of Tawheed, and inshallah, a residence of Quran, and a residence of the Sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So inshallah, we can live in peace, and we can die in peace. And in the hereafter we'll be in peace and we'll be among the companion of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in paradise. Brother, before I say قُولُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, I'm going to say know your enemy and enough is enough. You don't have the luxury of time or energy or opportunity and it doesn't worth it. Know your enemy, declare war against that enemy because the time is now. He's taking you away from Allah's mercy and you are helping out. Stop. Ibad Allah, قولوا لا إله إلا الله تفلحون. And that means I am committing myself to obey none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibad Allah, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح أقام الصلاة أقام الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله